Well, we've been seeing them a lot more lately. Interpreters standing alongside public officials at press conferences. One interpreter tells us this outbreak has drastically changed their field. News 13's Brittany Bade is here with more.
Kim, there are only a handful of deaf interpreters in New Mexico, and their goal is to ensure everyone has access to crucial public health information.
There's usually three for press conferences. I need one to work directly with me. So the two of us are considered on, and we're interpreting for about 20 or 30 minutes or so, 20 minutes. And then at that point, we switch out to the other interpreter, give us a chance to rest our minds because it's mentally taxing. If you can continue longer than that, you will make mistakes and it will lead to not accurate information.
Freelance interpreter Nixo Lanning tells us before the coronavirus, she was working part-time at CNM teaching ASL. Since the pandemic, she has been working around the clock at various public press conferences. The National Association of the Deaf, or NAD, is advocating for that across the country. Lanning says they are also being used in the workplace for virtual meetings.
Appointments, you name it, we're there for really communication access for the deaf person as well as the hearing person. You know, coronavirus has hit and the social distancing policy has applied, and so we can't really be there in person. Everything has changed to remote interpreting.
Interpreters are also helping at hospitals, working with healthcare workers to treat patients who are hard of hearing since they are wearing masks more. The NAD helps translate remotely for those patients to understand what is going on while social distancing. Kim.
Okay, thanks, Brittany. Now, all 50 state governors are now using ASL interpreters during coronavirus briefings. According to ZipRecruiter, deaf interpreters in New Mexico make about $25 an hour.